All plants need water, light, and air. But different kinds of plants are found in all sorts of environments, from hot and dry to cold and icy, and everything in between. So how do plants survive in such diverse conditions? They have amazing adaptations, inherited changes that help them live in their environment. All living things have adaptations, even you. When it gets really hot outside, you start sweating. Your ability to sweat is an adaptation to heat, because when the sweat evaporates, your body cools down. So, what do plant adaptations look like? In dry deserts, water is a precious resource. Some cacti, like the prickly pear, have shallow but far-reaching root systems that allow them to catch limited rainfall from a large area. Like the prickly pear, the saguaro cactus also has a large and mostly shallow root system. It also has one very long root that allows it to reach water deep underground. The saguaro stores its water in its cylinder-shaped stem and arms, which are also covered in spines to protect it from thirsty animals. Like the saguaro, the boab tree stores water in its bottle-shaped trunk. If you touch the trunk of the boab, the water-filled wood feels spongy. This adaptation helps it to survive in the dry Kimberley region of Australia that it calls home. Having access to water isn't a problem for the water lily. It's all around. But it can be hard for light to reach all parts of the plant. The water lily's broad, flat leaves, which float on the surface of the water, help it to gather more sunlight. In dense rainforests, it's hard for light to reach through the treetops and down to the forest floor. Epiphytes, like this bromeliad, grow high up on trees so they can have better access to the sun. Epiphytes are also called air plants. When winter arrives, how do you deal with the cold? Plants have their own adaptations to make sure they can survive the cold. North America is home to many deciduous trees, such as oaks and maples. They shed their leaves every year to prevent them from being damaged by cold and frost. Evergreen trees, like conifers, don't have leaves that fall off. Instead, they keep their needle-like leaves year-round. These needles survive cold and dry conditions because they are thin and waxy. Adaptations can protect tree seeds, too. In winter, pine cones close their scales to protect the seeds inside from wind and ice. What can we learn from plants? There's a lot that humans can learn about survival from plants. Copying from nature is called biomimicry, and it's been around for thousands of years. The gerbil people of North Queensland in Australia noticed that while the wait-a-while vine's curved hooks helped it to catch onto other plants as it climbed upward through the rainforest, it was also good at catching onto people walking by. They exploited this feature by using the plant for fish hooks. Even today, biomimicry continues to provide us with great ideas. For instance, the tiny bumps on lotus leaves help to keep them clean, and scientists have applied this lotus effect to fabrics and solar panels. Have you ever used or worn anything with Velcro? That's biomimicry too. The fabric was designed to mimic the tiny hooks on burdock burrs. Next time you're walking through a park or the woods, look around you. What adaptations can you see that help plants survive in their environment?
If you like this video, you can find it and so many more at clickview.net. Sign up for free today.